Yo, what up guys, this is your boy Kofi the Kill Sports Talk back at with another video. Today we are going to be discussing three reasons why Ryan Poles should keep Justin Fields for next year. But before we start my video, make sure to like and subscribe for my content and make sure to hit that notification bell so we can get the latest and greatest updates in regards to Chicago Bears and NFL news. But without further ado, let's dive into this. Today's video, we're going to be discussing Justin Fields. And I'm going to give you three reasons why Ryan Poles should keep Justin Fields. Now, there are many detractors that were talking about Fields, saying that, oh, he's a bust. He's busting Fields. He can't read the field well. He fumbles the ball. His ball security is not good. He's only focused on one read. And in some regards, it is true. I'll give you that. Justin Fields, he has to clean up his ball security because in the past 3 years, he's had 33 fumbles. And that's something that he has to work on, his ball security and knowing his situational awareness. I get that. I definitely get that. He also, like, there's some things that he does have to work on, you know, with his reading his defenses, knowing when to stay in the pocket. But he's just like any other quarterback in the NFL. No quarterback is perfect in the NFL. Patrick Mahomes has his flaws. Josh Allen has his flaws. Jalen Hurts has his flaws. Lamar Jackson has his flaws. But guess what? They're still some of the best players. And not only that, they have a great situation, a great coaching staff, and a great organization that puts them in position to succeed. And I'm going to give you three reasons why the Chicago Bears should keep Justin Fields. Reason number one, Justin Fields has steadily improved year after year. Now, prior to his injury against the Minnesota Vikings, through weeks 4 and 5, Justin Fields was third in the NFL in passer rating. He was third in EPA, expected points added, third in points per pass, third in yards per attempt, and first in touchdowns with 11. The two players at that time who he trailed were, of course, Josh Allen, who was an MVP candidate, and Brock Purdy at that time. Now, going into week 12 or week 13, he still got more passing touchdowns than Trevor Lawrence. And you see what he is doing right now with the Jacksonville Jaguars. He has 12 touchdowns right now. Now, on paper, it may not seem like it's all cookies and candies in regards to the NFL, because we definitely know that this NFL is a passing league. But in regards to the situations that Justin Fields has been in, he's had to overcome so much adversity, going through two different coaching staff, going through three different offensive coordinators, and Nagy, Bill Lazor, and Lou Getsy. Like I said, two different coaching staff. He had to go through three offensive coordinators, a makeshift offensive line, a makeshift offensive line that's been injured. And these last two games, Justin Fields has been playing with the starting offensive line. And look how he's played. He's been playing well. You know, I know last game, I know against the Minnesota Vikings, he didn't play that well. But Luke Getsy put him in those types of positions. Like this past game, Luke Getsy ran 19 screen plays this past game. 19 screen passes this past game. He didn't run any slant routes. He didn't run any hitch routes. He didn't run no RPO plays to combat the blitz that the Minnesota Vikings were running. And we definitely know their defensive coordinator, Brian Flores. Their defensive coordinator, Brian Flores, you know, he runs a blitz-heavy package. He ran 58% of the blitz-heavy package against the Chicago Bears, to try to throttle Justin Fields. And granted, it did work for most of the game. You know, they didn't score any offensive touchdowns, but you definitely see some of the plays that he was making. Like, you definitely saw that play he made when he evaded the Daniel Hunter sack. He evaded multiple pass rushers in order to move the ball and to move the chain. And you're not going to see that from a lot of quarterbacks. I mean, you could probably name one or two that may be able to do it, but in terms of that difficulty, the way he was able to extend plays, the way he was able to move out the pocket and throw to open receivers, just shows you how much potential Justin Fields has to be a top 10 quarterback in this NFL. Second reason, the Carolina Panthers are definitely not going to fumble that number one draft pick. The Carolina Panthers, you know, they just lost their last game to the Tennessee Titans, and they just fired Frank Reich. They have an owner, David Tepper, who pretty much acts with his emotions, a type of owner. You know, the fact that he was able to give a haul to the Chicago Bears because he thought that Bryce Young was the number one consensus quarterback in the 2022 draft shows you that he put a lot of his emotions into it. He didn't really think analytically about Bryce Young had, or even the fact that the offensive line that he has is not even that great. You know, and you got to account for his size too. You know, he's not a big guy. He's only like 5'9", 5'10". He's not going to be able to see over the field with a lot of those big offensive linemen. And so with the Chicago Bears, they need to not draft a quarterback, because I do not think Caleb Williams or Drake May are in the same type of stratosphere that Justin Fields is. You know, Justin Fields, he's only 24 years old. He's a young cat, man. Very young guy. You know, and he still has a lot to improve on. You know, like I said, he's got to work on his ball security placement. That's something that Jalen Hurts had a problem with. That's something Allen had a problem with ball security. But guess what? They kept improving year after year. And you see that they're some of the best quarterbacks in the league. And I think Justin Fields is in those conversations of some of the best quarterbacks in those leagues. And if they keep Justin Fields at least for one more year, maybe keep him for a fifth year option, they're definitely going to see the type of improvement from the Chicago Bears team, from just a rebuilding team to a playoff team. And with that number one pick, you could either draft Marvin Harrison Jr. from Ohio State, or you could probably get a haul and build around the trenches, build the defensive or offensive line for Justin Fields, and probably get some other good wide receivers, because granted, Marvin Harrison Jr. is a great generational talent for the Ohio State, from the Ohio State Buckeyes, one of my favorite schools in the nation. But there are other, great wide receivers, but they're solid wide receivers in the draft. That's another thing that the Bears need to keep in line with. Reason number three. The NFC North has its question marks. Now, granted, the Detroit Lions are playing well, but I don't think they're going to be good beyond 2025, because they still got Jared Goff as their quarterback. And Jared Goff, don't get me wrong, he's a solid quarterback, but in my honest opinion, I don't think he's the type of quarterback that puts this team over the top. You know, I think we kind of see the ceiling that Jared Goff has. Now, granted, he's having a career year with the Detroit Lions. Don't get me wrong, Detroit Lions are a really solid team, but I think Jared Goff, he has a type of ceiling to him, and I don't think that he'll be able to carry this team to the Super Bowl. Maybe I'm wrong, maybe I'm right, but to me, he doesn't have that type of ceiling like Justin Fields has in order to take his team to the top. Jordan Love, I mean, he's another solid quarterback. He has a great coaching staff. you know, with Matt LaFleur and all those guys on the team. He has a great defense and all that. But I feel like I said, Jordan Love, he has a ceiling too. Like, he doesn't have that type of talent or potential that Justin Fields has, and even Kirk Cousins too. Kirk Cousins, another great quarterback, Pro Bowl quarterback. He's a great quarterback. He can sling the ball. Last year, he threw for over 4,000 yards. He's great. But if you look at the eye test with some of these quarterbacks in the NFC North, they don't have that it factor. They don't have that type of talent, per se, their team to the Super Bowl. Justin Fields has that type of talent. And you definitely saw that against the Minnesota Vikings. You know, when he fumbled the ball twice, the defense was able to do their part, but he was able to shake it off. Justin Fields was able to shake it off. He was able to move the ball downfield, throw that 35-yard dot to DJ Moore, and that is what sealed the game. That is what we need. We need a mentally tough quarterback. I wouldn't say you need a quarterback that just puts up stats and puts up numbers, but you need a quarterback that'll be able to be mentally and emotionally tough to take on key situations, key situational games, like what Justin Fields is. Now, granted, you know, there are some games, certain games where Justin Fields did fumble the ball, but for most of the games that he did play on in tight situations, like even last year against the Miami Dolphins, that wasn't even on him. You know, he threw the ball to Equanimee St. Brown. He dropped it. Last year against the Minnesota Vikings at their home U.S. Bank Stadium, Amir Smith-Marset dropped that ball. He fumbled it. Against the Washington Commanders, he put the ball right on the money where Darnell Mooney was able to get it, but he wasn't able to catch. He got tackled. And it's not on Justin Fields, man. People keep talking about his QBR record like it's supposed to be on him. It's a team record. You have to understand that if you do not have the organizational backing behind your side, if you do not have the front office, if you do not have the right ownership behind you or backing you, you will never ever succeed. You won't succeed in the NFL. It doesn't matter what quarterback you put in there. You could put Tom Brady on this Bears team, but if the Bears team don't have the right structure and the right organizational structure to put Tom Brady in the right position to succeed, he's never going to be successful. And that's any other quarterback. And this is what Justin Fields has been going on throughout his 3 years in his time in Chicago. And like I said, Bears fans, we need to stand behind Justin Fields. You know, as long as he's wearing that Chicago Bears uniform, as long as he's wearing that C on his helmet, we need to stand behind him and stop having this so-called civil war, and start being behind Justin Fields, because I do think that Justin Fields has that potential. He has that potential to take this team to the Super Bowl. Hell, even win a Super Bowl, maybe even win a couple Super Bowls, but only time will tell. If Ryan Poles is able to make the right decisions, Ryan Poles and Kevin Warren are able to make the right decisions in terms of whether or not they want to keep Matt Eberflus and Luke Getsy and this whole coaching staff, or find another one. There are a couple candidates. I know the most famous one of everybody has been talking about, Jim Harbaugh. But, I mean, we got to see what Kevin Warren and Ryan Poles are going to do for this future of the Chicago Bears. But, like I said, guys, those are my three reasons why Ryan Poles should keep Justin Fields for the foreseeable future. But that's the end of my video, guys. And as always, guys, Chicago up, Bear down. This is your boy, Kofi. I'm signing out. Peace. That's why I'm trying to make a better way. Whole new crib in a better place. Get my people out the hood. We'll see better days. Tell a fan, sorry, y'all let them wait. Shit up there like a Saturday. Listen to me, happy. Beat up like a battle.